Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I'm the Razor Blade Pro, and I want to show you how to use Metro Boomin sounds right from Razor Music to build out trap tracks. So if you don't have these sounds, you're missing out completely. I'm going to leave a link right below the video so you can follow along with these sounds. Okay, so firstly, warning, these sounds are extremely loud and leveled to hit. So you want to make sure when you're previewing in your browser, turn the levels down. Okay, you might blow out your ears. Okay, so Metro was really serious when he said leveling is the key. So anyhow, let's turn these up and let's start with a melody. Let's start with something bell-like. So let's open up Omnisphere. Let's go to Bells and Vibes. And what I like to do is always discover something in Omnisphere. There's so many sounds. There's like over 10,000 sounds. So instead of going through each sound, I like to hit shuffle. And discovery is the key to writing great music. So let's click on something random. Now I can tell just from the picture, this is probably going to sound very film-esque, but it sounds cool. Let's try playing D minor, DFA, and split it up. So all I'm playing is DFA and then backwards, AFD, and then back to A. Let's show you what that looks like. Actually, let's start the tempo. So we're gonna dum 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 dum. Restretch, yes. I'm gonna crank it up until. So I think 158 is where we're gonna start. One of these samples is time stretched. I don't feel like figuring out exactly which one. We'll figure it out once we hear it. Watch it be the one way at the bottom. It's gonna be one way down here, something that. If it's the last one, this would be too hilarious. Oh, here it is. Change it from auto to resample and right click your time, change it back to none. That way it doesn't sound weird when you hit the key. All right, so now that's good. You won't get that message anymore. Just a little FL Studio tip. Now let's start by recording our melody. I might go down an octave. I like that, but I liked when I also played G by accent. So I'm going to create a change up. Let's start in the higher octave. Record, notes and automation. I'll show you the MIDI in a little bit. Let's just start with DFA, FA, and then backwards in a higher octave, AFD, and then back to A. Now I want to record a part that plays D, F, A, G, G, D, A. So I'm going to do, wait. Yeah, let's do that. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know why it plays a different tone based on velocity. So this is very velocity sensitive. So this is the second half, D, F, A, D minor, and then backwards, F, D, A. Oh, this is the original. I swear I played G. Maybe I'm tricking myself. Oh, you know what I was saying? G, I meant to say F. Okay, that's why. So instead of starting at the fifth, we started at the third, going backwards to the fifth. Let's switch out the sound because this sound changes based on velocity. I'm not sure why it goes random. I like the sound, but it has a weird change up in the programming. I like this one. Let's hear what it sounds like reversed. I'm going to print this to audio. Thank you. Oh, that little that sound, that's gonna sound really cool reverse. So let's find it in the mixer. It's track one. Let's open up Edison. And the reason I'm doing it in Edison and not Grossbeat is because we're gonna reverse the whole sample. Okay. Let's do it this way. Record on play. Now go to your playlist and make sure you leave something to the right so there's a gap. So as you can see, the Razer Blade Pro can handle a ton of instances of Omnisphere. We have how many instances? 3 instances of Omnisphere. So Omnisphere is a huge workhorse, and you can see the Razer Blade Pro is handling that. A lot of people had that question. They were asking me, how much can it handle? Let's grab the song jump, hit send to playlist as an audio clip, as it processed. Let's turn off the audio. That's a little off, so we need to realign it. But before we realign it, let's flip it in reverse. So let's click here, go to channel settings, go to reverse, and it's gonna realign the audio anyhow. See how cool it sounds? So now you might be like, okay, how do I, you know, where, what is what? So you need to think of it in reverse. Go to your snap to grid to none. You wanna line it up in reverse. So you wanna look at the transient peak at the beginning and line that up with a vertical column. That's the beginning of your sound. And we're gonna measure from that point, not the left side, the right side. So now you have that. Grab your slice tool, snap to grid, go to bar, hit shift, right click, get rid of the excess, and then move your audio back to the left. Now we can do more stuff to it. So let's click here, go to channel settings. I'm gonna, you know, you can, when you time stretch it, we didn't even time stretch it yet. Well, let's say you wanna time stretch. You go to your audio clips in the top left, go to stretch mode, and then left click, make sure you're on snap to grid bar. So if you're at 8 bars, you wanna drag it out to 16 bars. And that's a really cool sound. Now let's say you don't want the pitch to change. Go to channel settings, go to your mode, go to stretch mode. That's gonna keep the original pitch. But what I want to do is pitch it down an octave. So let's pull the pitch down negative 1200 cents. Now let's work on some drum rhythms. Now what I might do is actually re-stretch it back. I'm not sure if I like that because it's so slowed. Let's drag it back. I do like a pitch down. Let's work on these drums. Let's go to pattern 3. Start using those Metro Boomin drums. Let's start with the kick. And where's our clap? We're gonna put the claps on the 3 and 7 count and the snare. Wow, these are loud. Even when I turn the volume down, they're loud. So again, these are really loud sounds. You wanna turn that channel input volume or use your fader. I'm gonna use one of these snares as a bounce. Just hit Control B to latch paste. Let's go to pattern 4. Let's start building out our hi-hats. I'm just gonna go nothing crazy. Now again, the sound is super loud. I even turn the volume down, it's still loud. So let's right click the hi-hat, go to fill each 2 steps. I think I've picked another hi-hat. There we go. So in this one, I'm gonna go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Let's add that in the playlist. Pull that hi-hat back and let's add an open hat. Just put it on the ands, 1 and 2 and. Now we're gonna add more melodies atop this track. Let's start with the 808. Now we're not gonna worry about the tuning of the 808. We're just gonna use it as if it were a kick. I'm gonna go boom, boom, boom. So I'm gonna hit control up. We're not worried about tuning the 808. I'm gonna do this by ear. So it's a little sharp, but let's pull that down to G. So boom, 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 boom. Then pull the rest down to G. I'm hitting shift down. Then I wanna go to the next pattern, make it unique so that it's a new pattern. Edit the pattern and let's start on G. I want to boom, 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 something like that. So let's add a note in here. I'm hitting shift to duplicate, left click. Okay, and let's duplicate those in the playlist. Highlight everything, go to playlist options, go to edit, merge pattern clips. Edit the pattern clip and hit control down to send everything down an octave. So the 808's more active than the actual kick. Let's add a cymbal in here. I know I have a cymbal. You can add triplet little rim shots in here. 1, 2, 3. Maybe it's a turnaround, you could do that, but that's optional. Where's our cymbal? I'm gonna add that on the downbeat. Secure the pad. Alright, so future we're good on this. Now let's add another element. I'm still playing with the same bells. Kanye West, Diamonds Are Forever. So I wanted to decide if I wanted to leave it on the downbeat or kind of in between. Probably gonna work best on the downbeat. So I'm gonna use both just to switch it up over time. Let's add another sound. We're gonna go to retro sounds. Synth, go to synth poly, then go to type, go to analog classic, and hit shuffle. And we're just gonna play this as a contrast. It has that kind of that vibrato that we're hearing a lot in modern music. So these are the sounds that pros are using. 1, 2, 3, 4. I lost my timing, so let's do that again. So it's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. So I have to count before. 1, 2, 1, 2. I think I'm gonna move it over. I lost my timing, but that's fine. We can always edit the MIDI. Let's go to snap to grid, half beat. Let's probably pull this over half bar. That wasn't the timing. I think that was the original timing. At the third instance of OmniSphere, notice how our CPU is not going crazy. We have three instances of the biggest plugin known to the man. No, let's go to, let's see. So the Razer Blade Pro is handling this. This is why it's a great choice. Where are we at? We need some kind of synth pluck. Let's go to type and analog classic, hit shuffle. And this could, let's see what we can do here. like that. I might switch out the sound, but I like that rhythm. Boom, boom, boom. So I might switch out the sound because it sounds a little brassy. We don't want it to sound brassy. I'm gonna get rid of the dun 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 dun. I don't like that walk up. It's like the regular rhythm. And now we're gonna just end it, but that's, you gotta get these Metro Boomin sounds. So click that link below to get them for free. So we're on the Razer Blade Pro. Click that link below to get these sounds, the Metro Boomin kit, for free. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.